they returned to the sacred valley of the Incas, the valley of the Urubamba. ...8,450 feet above sea level lies Machu Picchu, a citadel also said to have been built by the divine race of light-skinned, auburn-haired descendants of Viracochas. Mysteries of the past manifest themselves on all continents. In the rough, hilly country of northwest Australia, there are scores of rock paintings which date back far in time. Drawings which are probably the earliest messages from prehistoric man. This sketch represents Wangina. Wangina was the legendary goddess of the Milky Way. She too came from heaven to instruct the children of Earth. Surely there were models, one is tempted to say one model, for these deities found on all continents. In Australia, in America, in Africa, in Europe, in Asia. This is one of the famous dogus of Japan. These figurines were found on the island of Honshu. They are at least 5,000 years old. Kazantsev, the Russian collector and expert, gave us his explanation of them.
In my opinion, these figures represent astral beings seen on Earth. Their sealed helmets are equipped with a breathing apparatus. Vision is afforded by glasses with narrow slits, like the Eskimos wear to avoid snow blindness. Probably they were accustomed to weaker light on their home planet. The cosmic clothing they wear seems inflated, as though to compensate for the higher atmospheric pressure on Earth. Their hands are not at all like human hands, but like mechanical claws. If you suggest they were but images of gods, I would ask you how their creators could have portrayed their technical accessories so accurately without having seen a model.
Kazantsev made one further point. He drew our attention to the amazing similarity between the Dogu figurines and the wall painting of the great god Mars, found halfway across the world.
The asymmetrical design of a piece of jewelry found in the tomb of a Mexican high priest can also be interpreted with startling results. If we superimpose a modern integral circuit on it, what we thought of as pure design takes on a new dimension.
Another example of Mexican ornamentation becomes, on completion, very much like a modern mechanical space claw.
Once again in Iraq, the museum in Baghdad, we find these small clay cups dating to the time of Christ. They may be even older. A small copper tube was introduced into the narrow neck. A rod, made of an alloy of different metals, was inserted in the tube. When filled with hydrochloric acid, the device produces an electric current.
This was no doubt a primitive electric cell. Yet Count Volta invented the electric cell 1,500 years later.
Another technical wonder from the same period in culture can be seen in the British Museum. It is a polished lens which could only be produced today with precision cutting and polishing tools. Polished lenses weren't executed in Europe before the 16th century, whereas this one was found in the Near East and is 2,000 years old.
In Moscow, near the monument to the astronauts, we spoke with Dr. Vyacheslav Saitsev of the Academy of Science. He called our attention to two prehistoric relics which simply cannot be explained by our present knowledge of history. The first is the skull of a bison which roamed the Siberian tundra 40,000 years ago. He was shot by a bullet.
The proof is the hole. Ballistics experts have established that it could only have been pierced by a high-speed projectile, and that the beast was alive when killed. A shot fired 40,000 years ago. Dr. Setsov's second example is equally startling. Outside of Fergana, in Uzbekistan, near the Chinese border, Soviet scholars found a rock painting which they carefully copied. We must look and look again to grasp the significance of this prehistoric drawing.
A creature wearing the headgear of an astronaut, the helmet well attached to his spacesuit, connecting tubes, breathing apparatus, the trappings of a space voyager. And suspended in the void, a spaceship shaped like two saucers, one atop the other.
Not only in Uzbekistan, but around the world, we've seen pictures of flying machines and flying creatures. Around the world, giants pose their silent questions. Around the world, we've seen architectural marvels raised in honor of the gods which came from the skies.
This flying machine was painted on a rock wall in Japan 7,000 years ago.
This tiny golden replica of an ancient flying machine is Colombian, over 1,000 years old. It was tested in a wind tunnel. The aerodynamic styling resembles that of a modern aircraft.
We thought it impossible that more compelling evidence for the visit of extraterrestrial beings to our planet existed. But they do. From the Pacific Ocean, we approach the coast of southern Peru. Before us is the Bay of Pisco. There, pointing the way, is a trident 300 feet high, obviously a signal.
A signal for whom?
We approach it once more. This sign has shown the way to the interior of the country for 2,000 years.
Shown the way to what?
Let's follow it and see. Passing over the ruins of ancient civilizations, at last we see before us the mysterious plain of Nazca.
Lines running toward us. Lines which would mean nothing from the ground. Long furrows cut into the parched soil. Cut there at least 2,000 years ago, scientists agree.
Thank you.
But do they really mean nothing? From a great height, from an aircraft, for instance, they fall into focus. We see a spider. An eagle. A peacock. And a hummingbird. None of which can be recognized from the ground. At no observation point, no mountain nearby overlooking the plain, the giant drawings must have been made for someone arriving by air. These other lines make no sense from the ground either.
Straight as arrows, one huge geometric puzzle, some parallel, some intersecting, starting nowhere and ending nowhere.
No doubt. They are landing fields. The plain of Nazca is a gigantic abandoned airport.
Could these be astrological symbols?
These indications are only visible from a great height. Who could have followed them? Or were they roads? Roads which go nowhere, which suddenly stop.
Yet, if it was an airfield, who was to land there? Do these figures answer our questions?
Was Earth visited by gods from distant planets? Were the gods astronauts? We've accumulated a great deal of evidence to that effect around the world. We may still doubt the conclusion, but we dare not ignore the evidence. For as long as such ancient mysteries remain unexplained, our questions are valid ones. Gods, astronauts. Do you suppose that once upon a time